गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम कांति सर एंड अगेन वेलकम यू इन अवर लेक्चर नंबर 12. यू नो वी आर इन लेसन नंबर 1 रेशनल नंबर्स एंड वी ऑलरेडी रीच टू असाइनमेंट नंबर 1.1. एंड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी सॉल्व एट लास्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, सब क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 एंड 2. एंड सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन इन होमवर्क ऑल्सो. So hope you successfully solving all sums and getting means understood also them. Now let's see next ones means question number 11, sub question number 3. You should keep your textbook with you, notebook, pen, everything. So whenever you want, you should note down. Whether it is solution, any rules, any shortcut, any basic related point, okay, that is must. Now 11.3, minus 2 by 5, minus 3 by 10, minus 4 by 7, it is very simple, just taking LCM is there. Even then, let we see, and I think it was given in homework also, but I solve here for the purpose that if you make any mistake, then you can compare your solution with this one and you can identify what type of mistake you are doing. So where are you weak at that? So it is minus 2 by 5 minus 3 by 10 minus 4 by 7. Okay, this is the question. First of all, you should combine the two consecutive sign are there. So here minus, this is just bracket. Actually, they should give here bracket, but not given. So we're not saying they are wrong, but it is expected here. So understand, we just opening here bracket, so minus plus here and here also. Okay, now you know 5 10 and 7, what is LCM? So let's find it. 5 10 7. Mostly we do here prime factorization, but if you can take bigger number also, which is means all number are divisible by that, then you can take. Here only 2 are divisible by 5, so let it take first, then 7 will be here. Okay, now 7 only. So 7 2 is 14, 14 5 is 70. 70 is the LCM, so I will write here whole fraction and multiply whole denominator by some appropriate number so that we get everywhere 70. How to find LCM, that you know. Why we are taking LCM, that you also know. Again, repeatedly I is telling one thing only, if fractions are there and addition subtraction are there, at that time LCM should be there. What is the process of LCM? LCM is nothing but a process of making all denominators equal. Okay, so now we getting here 70 everywhere. For that purpose, you look here, we should multiply here by 14, 14 5 is 70, here by 7 and here by 10. So 14 5 is 10, 7 is 7, 10 is 70, obviously. Now multiply by same number here also, 7, so here also 7, here also. Actually we want a denominator, but we have to multiply numerator also, otherwise fraction only become different. Okay, it will change only. So it is minus 28 upon 70 plus 21 upon 70 plus 40 upon 70. originally they are minus, but here due to subtraction becomes plus. So now you can combine old numerator. So it is minus 28 plus 21 plus 40. According to Bodmer's rule, first of all same signs combine, not 28. So just combine them, so it will be 61. So minus 28 plus 61 upon 70. Okay, now opposite signs are there, so you have to take difference and apply bigger one sign. So you get 11 minus 8, 3, 5 minus 2, 3. So it is 33 upon 70. Bigger number is plus, so I put here plus, means nothing is there, means positive term is there. So no cancellation possible, because 11 and 3 are factor of this one, and in 70 no 11 over 3 factors. Okay. So this is our final answer. We always give our final answer in simplest fraction. Simplest fraction means what? You know. Okay, you can note down it. Otherwise, you can take screenshot also right now, so that at last you can copy it. I hope you also solve and got 33 by 7, because it is given in previous lectures homework. As I told you, mostly I solve homework sum also, but not wait till next lecture. You just solve as your best, send, and you have copy also, that hard copy, so just compare it. And whenever I give homework at that time, I will always give you hint if anything is new there. Understood? So it is, never you have any excuse that I don't know or I not solve, cannot solve. Because if you try, you can. And in very first lecture I told you, always you solve that sum which are already solved in lecture. Okay, yourself only, in exam condition. Close your book, no solution in front of you. Whenever you stop anywhere, means you cannot proceed, you have any problem, at that time only look there. And what is the wrong, just identify. After that, try again, try to solve it and continue your trial, since you get perfectly first to last step, means whole sum accurately, then only you consider that sum is done. Otherwise sum is done, exercise done, means what? Sir, have you explained? No. You just written in fair book? No. You just read it once? No. Until and unless same sum you solve successfully in exam condition, then and then only you consider that is over, otherwise not. So your strategy should be that only in each and every sum, because mathematics can be studied in this way only. This is the only way, no other shortcut. Okay, so hope you follow it. And I also reminding you, I gave you example of teacher here, maths teacher. Math teacher never stand here just like that and deliver lecture, because it is not the subject of giving lecture or listening that. We have to do here something, means board work is must for us. Same way, notebook work is must for you also. Understood? So I hope you doing same way only. What I am telling here is nothing new there. Not any secret I am telling you. But if anyway you are thinking somewhat different way, then you must follow this path only. This is the only way. okay? And if you practice and habituated regarding this way of studying maths, then it will be very useful. And if any students not interested in maths, he or she feeling that it is difficult subject, then quite different result may obtain. And it will be interesting subject also. It can be converted into interesting one, and you will be very good at mathematics. Okay, if you follow this path, if you cultivate this habit, understood? So now let's see second one, means fourth one here. कि 1/2 इंटू 1/4 माइनस 1 इंटू 1/4 प्लस माइनस 7/18 डिवाइड बाय, सॉरी हियर इज प्लस, ओके 7/-15, ओके दिस इज द क्वेश्चन ओनली. नाउ यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सिंप्लीफाई वॉट एवर इज इन ब्रैकेट, सिंप्लीफाई ब्रैकेट ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंग टू बोर्ड मास रूल. सो इट विल बी 1/8 ओनली, नथिंग एल्स, बिकॉज नो कैंसलेशन इज देयर. यूर ऑल्सो 1/4 ओनली. नाउ बिफोर डूइंग एनीथिंग, जस्ट कन्वर्ट दिस साइन division into multiplication. How? By reciprocating divisor. What is divisor? You know, second fraction is divisor. Okay, now you can simplify here. It will be minus minus plus, here left minus 1, okay, here 1. So 15/18 will be there. So 1/8 minus 1/4 plus minus minus plus here 15/18. Again same case, take LCM. Why? You can see here fractions are there, addition subtraction is there. Okay, so let's take LCM of 8 4 18. So far understood how we simplify here. 1/2 1/4 is just multiply, numerator numerator denoted here also. Now this sign is being converted into multiplication so that divisor is reciprocated. 7 7 cancel out, so here minus minus plus 15 15 1 18 1 18. 8 4 and 18 are denoted, so take LCM. First of all divisible by 2, so 4 2 2, sorry 9. Now again by 2, so 2 1 9. Again by 2, 1, 1, 9. Now 1 alone is there, so write down 1, 9, 1, 7, 9, 1. Okay. No so many step required. So 9, 2 is 18, 2 is 36, 2 is 72. Okay. So 72 should be here. Okay, so get anyway means by multiplication only. 72 by 9 into 2 18 18 into 2 36 36 into 2 72. This is my process in my rough, not in fairberg. How to find LCM? So LCM will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 9. You can count, it is 72, means it can be obtained from first number, second number, third number, from all number. So this is the common multiple, means can be obtained from all denoter by multiplication. That is the meaning. And least only, you can obtain 144 also, but least multiple. Okay, so here 8 into 9, Here 4 into 18. 18 4s are 72. In here also. 4 18s are 18 4s are 8 9s are. Okay. By same number multiply numerator also. So it will be 9 upon 72, 18 upon, don't cancel them again, no? Otherwise you will come here only. So don't again cancel them, it is meaningless totally. And 15 fours are 16. So 72, common everywhere. 9 minus 18 plus 60, again addition only, first means same sign to be combined. Okay, so 69 minus 18 means show it here only, first of all, then go ahead. 69 because both are plus, this is minus, so now they combine and subtraction will be there obviously. So 69 minus 18, 9 minus 8, 1, 6 minus 1. So 51 upon 72. Now you know 5 plus 1, 6, 7 plus 2, 9 means divisible by 3. Divisible by 3. So it will be 3 into 17 and will be 3 into 24. 24, 3s are 70. So write down at last, answer is 17 by 24. Okay, whatever left, that is your answer. And I show here each and every step of taking LCM. That's why so many steps are there. Otherwise, you may thinking that why sum is so long, but it is not long. You can come directly also here. If you know directly, it's for getting 72. Suppose I want to come directly here, then what to do? 8 9 is 1 8 a, sorry, 8 9 is 1 9 is 9 directly. 4 18 is 1 into 18. 18 into 4 is, so 15 into 4 is, so you can come directly here also, no problem. Okay. Okay, now note it down. Number 12, the product of two rational number is given. If one of them is given, then find the other. Means it is very simple. I say product is 15. If one number is 5, then find other. I say product is 15. If one number is 5, then how you find other number? 15 divided by 5, 3 obviously. Okay. Otherwise you can suppose temporarily that numbers, okay, 15 is there,
but product of two numbers. Product of two numbers is 15. One number is 5. Temporary suppose another number. So you can say 15 divided by 5. Otherwise you remember directly product upon first number is equal to second number. You can do direct, but I think it will be systematic. So again read the statement and try to understand. So I just suppose here required number. So let other number, they are telling it's find the other. Let the other number be x. Therefore, product is given. Okay, you can write statement also. Product of both numbers is how much? 5 by 18. And be careful, this is product and minus 3 by 20 is first number. Sometimes students mix up them, interchange them. So obviously your answer will be wrong. Okay, one small mistake may lead to your whole solution wrong. So be careful when you reading the question and whenever you making equation at that time also. So 5 by 18 is the product of both number. So I should write it right side. Now out of this one number we supposed, in one number they have given minus 3 by 20. Okay, so shift it there. So x equal to 5 by 18 into 20 upon minus 3, because multiplication to division means all fraction getting inverse there. Obviously, denominator to numerator, numerator to denominator, and don't minus to plus, because it is different thing. If it's like that, then only you can write there 5 by 18 plus 3 by 20. This is different thing, because this is independent term here. This is factor only, factor of x only. So factor is shifted at that time only, division will be there, not just like minus to plus. Minus remain minus only, whatever sign remain there only. Okay, so this both case are different here. Look carefully. Okay, now I think cutting is not possible. Okay, minus 3 by 20 given, 5 by 18 we got, we just try to find. So nothing is possible here, just by 2 you can divide it. 2 tens are and 2 nines are, nothing else. Okay, so it will be 10 5s are 50 upon minus 27. And mostly we assign the sign to the numerator. Okay, so you can say minus 25 divided, and at last whenever you suppose anything at that time, your last answer should be in statement, because x is our own, it is supposed by us only, not given by them. So you should give answer in their language only. Their language means what they ask, other number. So we should say other number is this. Okay, so just this statement only, whatever suppose, give it last, but instead of x, write down what is answer. So therefore, the other number is 50 upon 27. As I told you, minus sign assigned to numerator only mostly. Okay, this is standard form of fraction. Standard form means whatever cancellation possible, just cancel it out. And if denominator is negative, assign this sign to numerator. Okay, now you can write it.
okay, and then 13 is in Homburg, same type of sum is there, same type is there, 13 in Homburg. I will write here.
Where from assignment 1.1.
Question number 13 means everything is clear. Now 14. Again, it is just like question number 8 and 9, just refer question 8 and 9 also given there in same exercise on same page only. Just look there. Okay, there are also sum of first two numbers is being subtracted from sum of last two numbers. Here product is given. Sorry, sum is divided from the product. So whatever they are telling, just do it first. So first make sum of first two numbers in 14 number. Okay, not in one step, step by step only. So sum of first two numbers, so it will be, first of all I write half a minus 30 upon 5 plus 12 upon 7. Again LCM, otherwise if co-prime numbers are there at denominator and two numbers only at that time, LCM or cross multiplication both will be exactly same. Two numbers only and denominators are co-prime, it will be cross multiplication only. So 35, 13 into 7, 91, plus 12 5 is 60. So here take difference, opposite sign subtraction, same sign addition. If it might be minus 91 minus 60, I might have been added there. Okay. So it will be 151 only negative, but here sign opposite, so take difference, this is different thing. And at last bigger number sign, so I priorly putting here negative sign and difference is 31. Okay. So this is the sum. Now they are asking product of another two number also, minus 31 by 7 into, product means multiplication, minus 1 by 2. Okay, no cancellation is there, so minus 31 by 14. Okay, so sum and product we, now write their statement again, but in simple form it becomes very simple. So now what they are doing, find the sum of, sorry, find, divide the sum, not divide sum, divide this number by the this number. So it will be very simple. So now I writing, instead of sum of those both, I writing minus 31 by 35. Okay, instead the sum of minus 13 by 5 and 12 by 7, instead of I writing its simplest form, by minus 31 by 14. Now it becomes very simple. And again here, what is divided by which number, it is very important. Sometime here also most of student exchange them and do just opposite what then what required. So here divide this one by this one, you understood? So this should be divided by that. So first number is divided by second number, simple sequence is there. I writing here that way, you can write here
vertically. So it will be minus 31 upon 35. And you know, we mostly remove sign of division by multiplication. How? By getting second number inversed. Minus 31, minus 31, cancel out. 7 into 2, 7 into 5, so it will be 2 by 5. Okay, so that is our final answer of question number 14. Sorry, here minus minus plus will be there. Be careful here. Minus minus, so it will be plus. Okay, so 31 by 14 will be positive. So here no negative sign. Okay, so here only negative sign is there. So minus 2 by. Okay, both are negative, so become positive. So accordingly, you write everywhere second number to be positive. Okay, second number positive here also, accordingly it is minus. Okay, now if you remember, try to recall, 15 and 16 were given in homework before many lectures. Whenever we were doing same type of examples there at that time. I just reminding you, 15 and 16. So just like same sum, example number 15. Example 15. Okay, we verify there for multiplication. Okay, so at that time I have given you this both sum in homework. So 15 and 16 in homework, just to verify how. Just write left hand side and put our value, simplify. Then separately write right hand side, put our value, simplify. If both becomes equal, that property or formula is verified. Okay, they are obviously equal. If you are getting different number, then obviously you committed any mistake there. So you can check that. Okay. So here, this exercise is already over. Now, somewhat different topic is there next one. It is to represent or place particular number on number line. What is number line? You know. It is one horizontal line. On this number, you have to denote rational number. Rational number means fraction, not 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, 3, 8. You can denote it very easily. But here, that types of fraction is there. Before starting there, let clarify here few things. First of all, there are type of fraction and mainly two, proper and improper. So understand what is proper fraction, what is improper fraction. Okay, P by Q means what? So here, if P is less than Q, then it will be proper fraction. Okay, and if improper fraction means what? If P is greater than Q, then only. So it will be less than 1 and this will be more than 1. Suppose I say 3 by 5, 2 by 7, 2 by 3, 1 by 4, 3 by 4, whatever number. If you convert it into decimal, then it will be 0 point something. And obviously I say 5 by 2, 3 by 2, 5 by 4. Obviously they are more than 1. It is 1.5. This is 2.5. This is 1.25. Okay. So you can say if numerator is bigger than denominator, it will be more than 1. And if numerator is less than denominator, then it will be 0 point something, means less than 1, suppose 2 by 3. So it will be 0.66, like that. So less than 1. Suppose 1 by 4, so it will be 0.25. Suppose 3 by 4, then it will be 0.75. 1 by 2, 0.5. Okay. So remember that, right? Now, obviously, if proper fraction is there, it is always between 0 and 1 on the number line. Why? They are less than 0, less than 1 and more than 0. So all these numbers are less than 1, means in own number line they are between 0 and 1. Understood? And improper fraction are far above 1. So right side of 1. It may be between 2 and 3, between 1 and 2, between 5 and 6. Okay? Understood? And second thing. Improper fraction, these are improper fraction can be converted into mixed fraction. Improper fractions can be converted into mixed fraction. How? By division. Okay, I giving you few examples. I hope you understood proper fraction, improper fraction. What if p is less than 1, p is less than q, here p is greater than q, means they are, another definition, less than 1. P by Q is less than 1, and here P by Q is greater than 1. And same way it is in negative numbers also. In negative numbers also this is possible, but there this sign will be quite opposite. Okay, we will consider it later on, not now. So either this definition, otherwise this, you can say. But this is more appropriate because in negative number sign will be reversed. And examples are also there. Now I telling you how to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. Proper fraction cannot be converted into mixed fraction. Not proper, improper only. So now taking few examples. Suppose 5 by 2 is there, so I can divide 5 divided by 2, so 2 2s are 4, left 1, don't go in point, now stop, so 2 is quotient, so 2 integer 1 by 2, because 1 still divided by 2, but we not going ahead, we don't want in decimal here, so 1 should be still divided by 2, and 2 is already quotient, so 2 integer 1 by 2. Suppose it is 17 by 3, then obviously 17. So here 2 integer 1 by 2. Suppose 17 by 3 is there, then 3 5s are 15, 2 left. Okay, so 5 is already quotient, so it is integer. Now 2 is being divided by still 3, so 2 by 3. Okay, and if you want again this fraction, this is 5 by 2, and second number I am giving you 17 by 3. If you again get improper fraction, then this 3 5 is 15 plus 2 17 by 3. 2 2 is 4 plus 1 5 by 2. So improper to mix, mix to improper. How to convert it? You can know. Now on number line mostly, we want whenever improper fraction is there, compulsory in mixed fraction. Then and then only you can know where it is. Because 2 integer 1 by 2 means what? It is between 2 and 3. 5 integer 2 by 3 means what? It is between 5 and 6. Because somewhat ahead of 5, somewhat ahead of 2. Okay. So after getting improper fraction into mixed one, then only you can determine ki where is it. If proper fraction is there, they are always between 0 and 1.
Same thing applicable in negative numbers also. It may be between minus 1 and 0. Here 0 and 1. Okay. And in negative number also, this way you can know if it is minus 2 integer 1 by 2, obviously it is between minus 2 and minus 3. Minus 5 integer 2 by 3, then obviously it will be between minus 5 and minus 6. Understood? So, again I giving you that rule also, you should note down it anywhere, even in textbook also you can note down here, because they are very important. First, proper fraction means what? If P is less than Q, then P by Q is proper fraction. Whatever we discussed so far, I just giving you systematically. If P greater than Q, then P by Q is improper fraction. Proper fractions are between 0 and 1 or between 0 and minus 1. If it is positive, 0 and 1, otherwise 0 and minus 1. Improper fractions should be converted in mixed one, mixed fraction. Okay, then only you know its location, means which between two numbers. Okay, so they are very useful. I think you should write it, remember it, learn it, understand it. Now I will show here roughly everything. You should do it in your notebook. One line should be there. Whether you draw your line on the your number or sorry on the line already in your book, otherwise in between two line also you can draw one line. Okay, and then line should be clear, both sides should be arrow. Okay, first of all you note it down so that I will remove it. Now we directly go to exercise only. Sorry, there is no this type of questions are there. Okay, no problem. Look at example numbers, 1.2, assignment number 1.2, right. Look at first of all main question number 2 in assignment 1.2. Because I will solve here assignments, then automatically you will understand examples. Okay, you just understand that after you do it. Otherwise, look at example 22, because I have solved so many here. So, example 12. No problem, then only we go to exercise, means assignment. Okay, 3 by 7. First one is 3 by 7. So, first of all, you can say it is proper. It is proper. Okay. So obviously it is between 0 and 1. As I given you, not also. Proper fraction are always between 0 and 1.
So draw your number line. In number line, in between 0 are there, this side 1, this side 2. But don't write priorly one number, because how many numbers are here in denominator? 7.
So you should divide that gap between 0 and 1 into 7 part. So I cannot write priorly year 1. Okay. 7 gaps should be there in between, then only 1 should be there. So you can take here gap of 1 centimeter, step of 1 centimeter. Suppose it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 7th one will be 1. Now you can go ahead and write down 2 also, but it is not necessary because it is between 0 and 1. We know.
So we know it's a rough location, but exit location now we can.
Okay, again, first decide whether it is proper or improper. After getting proper, you just very easily say it is between 0 and 1. If it is improper, convert it into mixed fraction, then only you know between which two numbers it will be. Then look at denominator. Okay, and take so many parts. Okay, here 7 is there, so I have taken here 7 part, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Means that gap is being divided into 7 equal parts. Gap between 0 and 1, we already know between 0 and 1, why proper is there.
Now, 0 and 1's in between gap should be divided, but priorly you cannot write 1. So you just try here to make 7 line, and on 7th line it will be 1. Now from this side you can say this will be 1 by 7, this will be 2 by 7, and exactly this will be 3 by 7.
Okay. If they ask 5 by 7, then I will write here. If they ask 1 by 7, then I will write here. Start from here, 0. Always start from this side, 0. And here also this side. Okay. Now, don't write both this number on same number line. Okay. Take another one. So, I just taking here minus 5 by 6. Okay. For same question. But sub question number 2, this is sub question number 1, number 2. Now it is minus 5 by 6. So obviously again it is proper because numerator is smaller. Now forget sign. First of all, consider that way. It is proper, but negative. So it will be between 0 and minus 1. So again, write down 0 here, not go that side, come that side. How many gaps should be there? 6.
So, at 1 centimeter gap, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At 6th number, it will be minus 1.
Okay, so proper fraction are always in this area, 0 to 1 or 0 to minus 1. What is proper fraction? You know, if numerator is smaller than denominator, it is proper one.
Okay, now it is minus 1 by 7, sorry, minus 1 by 6, because it's divided by 6 every, minus 2 by 6, minus 3 by 6, minus 4 by 6, minus 5 by 6, start from 0 only, either this side or this side, so it is minus 5 by 6, don't denote remaining one,
whatever asked, denote that only, and no other number should be denoted here. If you want, you can. You can write here again 6th line, and you can write 1 also, but they will be blank. That gap will not be useful there. Even you can proceed here minus 1 to minus 2 also after again 6th gap. Okay. But we generally expect particular gap only in which that number is. Okay. So I hope it is very simple for proper and you understand.
Okay, so many gaps should be there in between. look at dinner or second step. Okay, now look at 23rd. It is 11/3. Okay, removing this one. They have denoted both number on same line, but we never. You also denote each number on single line only. So so many questions are there, so many number lines will be there. So it was 22, now 23. 11 by 3. So divide in rough 11 by 3. 3 3s are 9. 2 left. So it will be 3 integer 2 by 3. So is equal to 3 integer 2 by 3. It is improper. Okay. If improper is there, convert it into mixed fraction. I have not written here, but you showed it. So it is converted. Now you can see it is between 3 and 4. Between 3 and 4. Why? Somewhat far from 3, ahead of 3. Okay. So again, number line. It is between 3 and 4. So start from 3 only. And write anywhere 4 here, but not priorly. 3 gaps are there. So 1, 2, 3. You can take bigger gap also of 1 centimeter, of 2 centimeter, of 1 inch. Anyway. So here it is 4. 3 gaps are there. Why? Denoter is 3. So I have taken 3. Now far of 3, it is 3 integer 1 by 3, 3 integer 2 by 3. So this is 3 integer 2 by 3. Repeating. First of all, it is improper. Why? Numerator is bigger. So I converted into mixed fraction by division. 3 integer 2 by 3. So I know it is between 3 and 4 because somewhat ahead of 3. So I return here 3 and 4. 3, then 3 step I go ahead and return 4 then. Now from 3 only start. 3, then 3 integer 1 by 3, 3 integer 2 by 3. Okay, same way minus 11 by 3 is there. So on separate line only you have to denote it. Same thing is there, only minus sign. So I have taken here minus 3 integer 2 by 3 directly. Now where it is? So it is between minus 3 and minus 4. Minus 3 and minus 4. So I write here minus 3. Now look carefully here. Imagine whole number line there. This side minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like that. So minus 4 will not be this side only. Again, 3 gaps. So 1, 2, 3. So it will be minus 4. Now we go here this side. Here from this number only you start. Okay. This way you have to go. Negative, positive. So minus 3 integer 1 by 3. Minus 3 integer 2 by 3. Okay. So it's very simple. Okay, I hope you understood. Even I explain everything. First of all, look at fraction, decide whether it is proper or improper. If proper, you can say directly it is between either 0 and 1 or 0 and minus 1. And look at denominator. How, what is number there? Get equal number of gaps there. Okay, if 3 is there, here 3 gap in between. If 5 is there, 5 gap. Then just start in positive left to right here, right to left means 3 to 4 here. Why? Because 3 and then 2 by 3. So 3, then second number should be there because 3 is 3 integer 1 by 3. We don't want 3 integer. Here also same thing. If improper fraction is there, you convert it into mixed fraction, then only you know in between which two number that number is. So same way now you can denote here also, mixed fraction also. Okay, and if you don't want this number, then you can write its original form also. Second one is actually what? Here look, minus 11 by 3. So you can write minus 11 by 3 also. Anyway, either in mixed form or in improper form, you can write it. Okay, now you look at assignment 1.2. Assignment 1.2. You can see question number 2 everywhere, they are proper one. And at question number 3, they are improper one. Okay, so I just giving you first 2. So now here question 2, 1, 2. In question 3 again 1 2, not all. Okay, single number on single line only, so many numbers means 4 lines should be there, not only one line 2 number should be there, be careful there. Okay, so it is very simple but somewhat time consuming, so you should finish it in a stipulated time only. Okay, so what is homework? Clearly written here from assignment 1.1, question 13 is there. From assignment 1.2, main question number 2, 1.2, and these are 1.2. Okay. Okay, students. So we end our today's lecture here only, and I hope you understood and you practice well for homework also. And before doing homework, you do this repeating means solve some again. Okay, thank you very much.